It's Brian and Pam.
Oh, yes, indeedy, the Cheshire Voice singers sounding great even while wearing protective masks. I'm Pam Landry, along with Brian Smith. It's the Podcast Not a Podcast quarantine series. And yeah, it's been months since our last episode. Wait, what? April 6th was... Oh, well, it seems like months. Anyway, this is episode 38. And just a reminder, our email address still working, icecreamsodact@gmail.com. While you're practicing your social distancing, please drop us a line. Happy to report I am still healthy and partially sane. Brian Smith, how are you?
Hey, Pam Landry. I am doing very well. Quite well, thank you very much. As sane as ever. And don't go looking into that too deeply. Anyway, just as Pam Landry just said, remember our email address is icecreamsodact@gmail.com and our YouTube address where you can find all our episodes of this podcast, not a podcast. It's all one weird word. Ice Cream Soda CT. And you can watch the episodes, you can contact us, just like Caroline the cashier does, and many other people who email us and listen to our podcast, not a podcast. Anyway, yes, I am also feeling the distortion of time and space. I think a lot of people are right now. The only thing that worries me, Pam Landry, is I'm talking to my appliances, specifically my coffee maker. That blue light is always on. It always needs more water. It's needy. Oh, give me more water. What do you do with all that water? Who's drinking all that coffee? And it just says to me, ain't nobody here but you, Shaky. Well, that's true. So I just give it more water and go back to business. Anyway, Pam, otherwise I'm okay. What have you been doing to keep busy, Pam Landry?
Well, Brian Smith, I'm keeping busy doing many different things. I've learned three new languages. I've earned an online PhD in psychology. I've turned my garage into a hydroponic garden. And I've started a craft brewery in my basement. Oh, wait, that's stuff I've read that other people have done. Actually, I don't even have a garage or a basement. But, Brian Smith, one thing I have done in an attempt to lighten what can often be a dark mood is I've collected some of my favorite humorous social media memes, you know, in relation to self-isolating and such. Would you like to hear some of them?
Why, yes, Pam Landry. I would love to hear some of your favorite social media memes. Wait a minute. Are you going to describe these to us? You're going to describe funny visuals? Well, I'm all for it. In fact, I am all for hearing anything that distracts me from my own inner monologue these days. Especially the inner monologue that starts out with, why don't you do something useful instead of hanging around all day? Or the inner monologue that says, why don't you take a shower this week? Or the... Oh, hang on a second. Those aren't my inner monologues. That's what my neighbors are telling me. So yes, Pam, I would love to hear your favorite social media finds this week.
Okay, Brian, and the social media memes I'm talking about are just words. There's no visual involved. Here's one I especially enjoyed. 2020 is a unique leap year. It has 29 days in February, 300 days in March, and 5 years in April. And then here's one. This was kind of visual. Instead of the I voted sticker, you know, that you get when you go and vote, the sticker says I showered. And then this one, Brian Smith. Day one of quarantine. I'm going to take this time as an opportunity to improve my health. Day two of quarantine. Due to personal reasons, I am eating lasagna in my shower.
Thank you, Pam Landry. Hang on. Pam, is there something wrong with eating lasagna in the shower? And just asking for a friend, of course. Just asking for a friend. Okay, if I can just borrow our little list there. Little internet magic. Let's do some more social media memes about our current crisis. not to brag, but I haven't been late to anything for over a month. And that's not exactly true for me if you're counting that Zoom meeting I forgot about last week. Here's another one. 87% of gym members don't even know their gym is closed. And another one. The drop in gas prices during lockdown is like a bald man winning a hairbrush. All right. And now back to you at the Landry Quarantine Desk for more with Pam Landry. Pam? Oh, and here's your notes back.
Why, thank you, Brian Smith. Let's see, there's just one more I want to add here. Another one of my favorite social media memes during this pandemic. Sometimes I wonder if all of this is happening because I didn't forward that message to 10 other people. Oh, and Brian Smith, on a separate note, during the first maybe couple of weeks of self-isolating, I found myself doing a lot of house cleaning. Bad news, my house is dirty again. So here's the thing. Why can't you just dust once and the dust stays away? Vacuum once and you don't have to vacuum again. So basically, I got sick of cleaning and my house is dirty again. So Brian Smith, I'm sure, like me, you've been reaching out to a lot of friends, either by phone or video chat. There are certain people I check on daily. You, for instance. No reason in particular, just because. Anyway, one of those people I stay in touch with is Yetta Auger, the president of the Cheshire Chamber of Commerce. And Brian Smith, Yetta is here to say hello.
Hi, Brian and Pam. It's Yetta from the Cheshire Chamber of Commerce. Myself and my chamber colleagues across Connecticut are working very hard to get accurate and the most up-to-date information out to our membership. Please safely continue to support our local businesses and restaurants. We are all in this together. Everyone be well and be safe. Stay healthy. We'll all come back from this and we'll be stronger than ever.
Thank you. That's Yetta Auger. She is the president of the Cheshire Chamber of Commerce. Pam, it's great to be able to check in with some of our friends who are running the various business organizations of some of the cities and towns here in the center of the universe, Southern Connecticut. Not an easy job in these times to try to keep these businesses up and going and informed, but they're doing it. Well, Pam, I agree with you on your house cleaning tips. I mean, doesn't dust get the idea? We vacuum because it isn't welcome. So when you get sucked up, go away and never come back. No, I'm seriously, and I know when I say I'm serious, you're thinking that means he's not serious, but I mean it. I'm seriously giving thought to wrapping all my furniture and bookcases with Saran Wrap. And I'll just unwrap it when I need it. Otherwise, no dust. Better than Saran Wrap, I'm even thinking of gift wrapping paper. So it'll be like Christmas or my birthday when I go to use that thing that I need. Like when I go to use that thing that theoretically heats up in my kitchen. The, what do you call it? Thank you. The stove. Right. Well, if I ever used it, I'd unwrap it. Well, speaking of local organizations, time to bring in another one of our associates, Gary Carleglio. And if that name sounds familiar to some of our Milford friends, Gary's father, Ray Carleglio, was the football coach at Jonathan Law High School for years. But now let's check in with North Haven and Wallingford with the senior director of sales and marketing for the Quinnipiac Chamber of Commerce, Gary Carleglio.
Thanks, Brian and Pam. Hope you're doing well. Gary Carleglio here from the Quinnipiac Chamber of Commerce in my basement office. We are all working remote. The chamber is up and functional. All of our staff are healthy. Dee, Maribel, and myself, and our affiliate, the Greater New Haven Chamber of Commerce, we're all doing well. We're here to serve you. Check out our website, quincham.com. That's Q-U-I-N-N-C-H-A-M, quincham.com, for all the latest COVID-19 response resources for businesses in town. We look forward to serving you. If you're a business out there and you need help in trying to get restarted with some marketing ideas, please contact Gary Carleglio, Gary at quincham.com. That's Q-U-I-N-N-C-H-A-M, Gary at quincham.com. Shoot me an email. Would love to chat. Brian and Pam, hope you're doing well. Thanks for your service, and look forward to getting back together with you. Thanks.
And we look forward to getting back together with you, Gary Carleglio of the Quinnipiac Chamber of Commerce. Oh, Brian Smith, look at the time. Got to wrap up this episode number 39 of our podcast, Not a Podcast, the Quarantine Series. So until next time, stay well, stay safe, keep up with that social distancing. Oh, and if you're a mom or you have a mom, happy Mother's Day this Sunday.
Thank you, Pam Landry. And yes, happy Mother's Day. Even if you just know a mom, call her up. It's a strange Mother's Day this year. She'll need it. And just like mom will always be here in our hearts, so will our email address. So tell your mom to listen to our podcast, Not a Podcast, and send us an email at icecreamsodact brian@gmail.com. Anything you got. Send us pictures of your quarantine art. Send us pictures of your quarantine hair. Send us pictures of your quarantine beer and meatloaf. Send us pictures of your quarantine mom. Give us something to look at besides the four walls every day. Thank you to Holly, our social media genius. Caroline, the cashier, and the rest of you frontline essential workers, medical people, first responder people, gas station people, car wash people, thank you all. And we'll see you next episode. Goodbye.